Several new developments in the wildfire in northern Wisconsin. First, the DNR has lifted a statewide burning ban. Also, the logging crew that sparked the fire won't face criminal charges. The Wisconsin DNR investigated the origins of the fire and determined it started accidentally when some equipment caught some dry grass on fire and the wind did the rest. 12 News reporter Nick Bohr surveyed the damage there in Douglas County.
It has been a day of assessing damage here, as well as contacting insurance adjusters in some cases. There were some 50 buildings destroyed by the fire, including this home, one of 17 homes destroyed in what was Wisconsin's worst wildfire in some 30 years.
You just look at the black everywhere around you and think, I don't want to be here.
Tom and Carol Plant drove up from their home in Heartland, arriving to find their summer home in ashes.
Generally, next weekend we'd have 9 guys here for Memorial Day to do some fishing and projects around, but not this year.
Despite the losses, the DNR points out they were able to save many more homes and buildings across the 8,000 plus scorched acres. And most importantly, they say there were no deaths or even injuries.
At one point, the fire was burning very intensely and moving very quickly, so the job the guys on the ground did was really spectacular.
This is one of the amazing things we've seen here. It looks like a chimney. This hollowed out tree continues to burn and smolder even a day after the fire first swept through here. And even as they wrap up their cleanup here, the DNR is warning people that the conditions that existed that allowed this fire to spread here so quickly continue to pose a danger. In Douglas County, Nick Bohr, WISN 12 News.
DNR crews used a plane overnight equipped with an infrared camera to detect hot spots. They've spent the day zeroing in on those locations and snuffing out any embers.